world aglow. Innocence, a wild place of shallow pools and deep coves, a world untouched but by the soul of antiquity. A world beautiful, all things beautiful, in a place of peace and aesthetic quality, beaming, streaming life's energetic right, the prerogative of all things beautiful. Yet presently we see life's horrifying plight, a world touched by the soul of a story told through generations of fooled inferiority's might. We invoke the devils within us and spoke, challenging, finish us, finish us. We open our hearts, minds, and bodies to hatred's swollen enmities. We gave them our feet and hands to seek and stand, swallowed in gluttony, starving quicksands. We fall into our knees, begging for the peace we had the courage to release, to send us on our way down a path of destiny's disarray. Untouched, unbothered, untainted, unhampered, grace. But we couldn't. We wouldn't accept such peace without proving our courage. To bore ourselves life's hell so we could find again our bravery's bodies. In the ages of our core, we swore to find all things beautiful once more. To find only traditions poor. Traditions poor. For we were, we are, we are the words which we say. We are the wind in which branches sway. We are the balance that keeps violence and peace at bay. We are the silence that stagnant mists splay. We are the harmonies to which life dances and plays. We are the spirit to which we pray. We are the spirit to which we pray. For all things beautiful, once more.